the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Welcome to the commencement for the Bristol High School Class of 2020. I'm Alicia Davila. Congratulations to the class of 2020. I know this year was not ideal. It was not expected to end the way it did, but I hope we can all say that we are thankful to be here to celebrate our graduates. Starting off the year, we knew that this was going to be one to remember, but it wasn't expected to be remembered like this. I know we are all upset at the fact that we didn't get to do many of the things that we planned on doing. I know I was one who spent a lot of time crying because I knew senior year was over. But in the end, I am thankful to say that I made it here today. I am thankful to be happy and healthy, and I am thankful that those around me are happy and healthy as well. I hope you can say the same. I can say that the class of 2020 will go down in history. We endured a lot of ups and downs, both good and bad, but we did it together as one. If there's one thing that this year has made me realize, is how we take the little moments in life for granted. We live in the moment, and we fail to appreciate those details that make our everyday lives. We started off this year thinking about prom, sports, graduation, and applying to colleges. We talked about everything that we were going to do and everything that we were hoping to accomplish. We started off planning our futures, but we were still living in the moment. We thought about our outfits for Spirit Weeks, and we never once stopped to think about what would happen if this all got taken away. We took the time that we had together for granted. Who could have imagined that Friday, March 13th, would have been the last day that we spent together as a whole? I know that we all complained about not wanting to go to school, about having too much homework to do. We even complained about not wanting to go to a certain class and see a certain teacher. But in the end, I know that if we were given the chance to get those moments we took for granted back, we would take it. As a class, we took each other and the time that we had together for granted. We have had our ups and downs, we've had our fights, our arguments, and even some misunderstandings. But in the end, I think it's safe to say that this class is like a big family. We have grown up together. Some of us have even been together since kindergarten. We may not talk every day, and some of us may only see each other in school, but we helped each other get through some good and bad times. School was the foundation of the amazing memories that we shared with our favorite people. I will never forget all of the memories that were made at school dances, pep rallies, sports events, and even in class. Those memories will be something that I hope we can all cherish and remember when we're older. Without the people that surround me here today, I would not be the person I am, and neither would you. I understand that some of us may not be friends, but whether we realize it or not, these people have shaped who you are and who you will become. Even the smallest interactions, those we took for granted, changed you and changed your way of being. 4 years ago, we stepped into a new chapter of our lives. We never realized that time would go by as quickly as it did. We made memories and we made new friends. During the past 4 years, our teachers have been shaping us to be prepared for our future careers. Sitting before me, there are future teachers, engineers, doctors, athletes, and maybe even future stars. I would just like to take the time to thank each one of the teachers for playing a major role in our lives. Thank you for dealing with us at our best and at our worst. We will never forget what you have done for us, and we appreciate your support. Personally, I would like to give a special thank you to Mr. Brown for showing me that I could accomplish what seemed to be impossible for me. I would also like to thank Ms. Mortimer for being a safe space to let my feelings out, someone who opened her doors to help those who needed it, and someone who always made me laugh. There is someone else without whom I would not be giving this speech today. I would like to thank someone who made a very big difference in my life a very long time ago. Someone who I thank every day. Miss O'Hara was the elementary school speech teacher. She took me from a kindergartner who could barely communicate due to my stutter to the speaker I am today. My last thank you is for my family. Thank you to my parents for giving me the support and that extra push that I needed to accomplish what I have today. Thank you for supporting every decision I have made in my life and every decision that I will make. Thank you to my brothers for being there for me when I needed you the most. Thank you for protecting me and supporting me. Thank you to my friends who have become an extended family for me. You are the reason school was easier and more bearable for me. I will always cherish the memories we have made. Make sure you all take the time to thank those special people in your lives. My hope is that everyone can take what has happened to us this year, sit down, and think about all the times you are given with those special people in your lives. Make sure to cherish those moments and never take them for granted, because this year we have learned just how quickly they can be taken away from us. I wish you all the best in the future, and I hope you can all accomplish your dreams and never give up. For the last time, I would like to say congrats to the class of 2020. Remember that the hard work is just beginning and we're entering into a new chapter of our lives. Remember, once a warrior, always a warrior. Thank you.
Members of the Board of Education, colleagues in administration, distinguished members of the faculty and staff, class officers, families, and most importantly, graduates. It is an honor to have the opportunity to offer remarks for the Bristol Borough School District's Class of 2020 commencement ceremony. This year's commencement culminates many years of dedication and determination by each of the 54 students who will receive a diploma this year. Each student found a unique path to earning a diploma, but the common threads that bind them together in this effort are the love, commitment, and support of their classmates, parents, and teachers who help make this night possible. Arriving at this moment is bittersweet for many of us. For students, it marks the end of this journey and the beginning of another, one I am certain they are anxious to begin. For parents, it is an evening that marks the true end of your child's time here in the Bristol Borough School District, a time that I am sure has gone by too quickly. And for the faculty and staff, it means saying goodbye to the many young men and women who are essentially the life of this district, the reason each of us come here daily. For parents, guardians, and family members of our graduates, this year's graduation must be extremely gratifying, considering the unprecedented conditions surrounding the past few months. I know that our seniors are grateful for the support you have shown, not only this year, but throughout their educational journey. For the past 18 years, you've done your part to ensure that your child receives the best education possible. Undoubtedly, they will always be the little boy or girl whose eyes you had to dry on the first day of kindergarten, or the child who used you as a taxi cab to haul groups of friends around to social events. Thank you for allowing us to share their lives and for trusting us with your most valuable resource. One of the most endearing concepts I drew from my first year here at Bristol Borough is our strong sense of community and acceptance. The mission statement of the district states, "The Bristol Borough School District empowers students to achieve excellence and become leaders in a global society through an education system immersed in the fabric of a unique and diverse community. Warriors work together to give back to those who are less fortunate and those in need." As is evident in the over 2,500 hours of community service performed by the class of 2020. Instilled in each of our students is a strong sense of importance, the importance of lending a helping hand or giving to those in need. Seniors, I challenge you to continue your commitment to doing for others. This commitment will help you deepen your impact on our local community and to strengthen the fabric that binds us together as a society. For those of you whose paths will take you away from home, community service provides a network for you to meet new people and to make a difference. Let the lessons of selflessness and kindness to others that you learned as a student be the guiding light as you begin your journey as an adult. Remember, you can make a difference. Former First Lady Michelle Obama is quoted as saying, "Don't ever underestimate the importance you can have, because history has shown that courage can be contagious and hope can take on a life of its own." Class of 2020, I hope that you take the strength and perseverance you have shown in overcoming the adversities you have faced in the past 3 months and use it as a springboard to conquer all of the challenges you will face in your life's journey. You are now the author of your own destiny. Consider the challenges placed before you as opportunities to grow and to learn what you are capable of accomplishing. It was a pleasure getting to know all of you over the past year. Thank you for welcoming me into your world and allowing me to share in this special day with you.
My fellow classmates, my friends, welcome to the virtual commencement for the Bristol High School Class of 2020. It is unfortunate that you will be hearing this over a recording and not in person as we had all hoped. But we must remember something. You are still hearing this, and that is an accomplishment that is not diminished by the current situation. We have been together for the last 4 years of our lives, nay, the last 13 years of our lives. There may have been bad times, but there have also been many good times, good memories, and it is those good memories that we must hold on to going into the future. I'll be blunt with you all. The world is in a state of chaos right now. There have been several moments in our lives that have changed the world forever. 9/11 attacks that occurred mere months before we were born. A global pandemic seen once in a century. And an innocent life taken that has brought demand for justice and equality. These events have shaped the world as we know it. And it is this world that we are being thrown into at full force. Some may feel that the future looks dark, but that does not mean there is no hope in this world. Look to the people who have responded to the loss of life that occurred on Monday, May 25th. To the sheer number of people that are raising their voices in support of the cause. The fact that there are thousands upon thousands of people going out and calling for change every day is a sign that there is hope for this world. And we must be the ones that inspire and deliver upon that hope. Many of us are already standing up for what we believe in, and I'll encourage each and every one of you to stand up for what you feel is right. We will have the courage to do so because of all the positive examples in our lives, our parents, our friends, our teachers that we've had throughout the years. Without them, I wouldn't have the heart that has allowed me to write this speech. We were born in the frying pan and are being cast out into the fire. We may come out scarred, but we'll be better because of it. We will forge a new path of our own making and set a precedent for the future. We will not remain silent. We will not allow ourselves to be pushed aside by those who deem themselves above us, and we will lift up all those who need our help. We are part of a new generation of people, a new generation of Americans that will not sit back and watch the world burn around us. We will use the fire to forge a better world. We all wish that this wasn't happening right now. We all wish that what was happening right now was never happening to begin with. But that is not for us to decide. What we can decide, however, is what we do with the time that was given to us. To the class of 2020, I'd like to leave you the following message. Time is a precious commodity, so do not waste a second of it. Make the best of each and every last second that has been given to you. Use it to change and improve our world, to make it a better place. Do the things you love, spend time with the people you love, and most of all, never regret a second of it. And congratulations.
Good afternoon. I am Gianni Quattrocci, and I am honored to be the Bristol High School Class of 2020 valedictorian. At this time, I would like to take the time to congratulate my fellow classmates for their dedicated efforts over the last 4 years, and especially the last few months. While we may not all be here in person, we are all one Bristol Warrior family celebrating an achievement we all worked hard to obtain. I would also like to thank school faculty who have all had to make enormous sacrifices and adaptations, both now and before the virus, to ensure that we all had the opportunity to make it here. They have given us the tools to carve out our success. I would also like to thank my family, my mom, my dad, and my two brothers, Aiden and Andreas, and my family watching at home. All of our families have given us timeless wisdom, life lessons, and advice and experience. I know I would not be here without the support and love of my family. Now more than ever, we see a constant demand to adapt. You can have a plan, but if your plan isn't built to withstand a curveball, it won't get very far. If these past few months have taught us anything, it's how unprepared so many of us are when faced with necessary adaptation. We divide ourselves, project blame to either side, and become more consumed in finding each other's faults than actually working together to find a solution. Whether it's schools being closed or an injury on the football field, we all must adapt and roll with the punches if we want to continue to persevere. The path to success is inconsistently paved, and we can't expect to reach our goal at the end if a bump in the road or a pothole is enough to stop us. Everyone wants to be successful, but this path isn't a one-way street. It is an arduous combination of hard work, perseverance, and adaptation. How many times are we willing to take detours, get knocked down, get back up? As important as hard work is in accomplishing our goals, it also isn't enough. You can work hard at trying to push open a pull door, but it will never open. It is our ability to work hard and adapt to obstacles and circumstances that give us the skills we need to succeed. Hard work and adaptation are also necessary to create lasting positive change. To quote Nelson Mandela, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. At school and at home, we have been given the opportunity to learn. Whether it was how to interact with people, solve complex problems, or work in a group, we have been learning day in and day out, regardless of whether we knew it or not. Throughout high school, I've heard claims that certain things we learn are irrelevant. When will we ever use the quadratic equation? Why do we need to know the meaning of Romeo and Juliet? Even if we never use that equation again or never read another Shakespeare play, we have still learned how to view problems from different angles and different points of view. No one can take our learning away from us. It was Nelson Mandela who also said, "May your choice reflect your hopes, not your fears." With the education we have been granted, when we go out to create change and when we adapt, we must still let our choices reflect who we are. As important as it is to adapt to change, we also cannot give in to the worst outcomes of it: fear, hate, and division. We must use our education to make a better world for us all and make informed decisions that promote our hopes and not our fears. We can all enact change, but it needs to be done wisely and carefully so everyone can benefit. To the class of 2020, I ask that you go out into the world, work hard, and adapt to face and overcome your obstacles. Use the tools of education you have been given to plant meaningful change in the world, make informed decisions, and make a better tomorrow for us all. And never forget, once a warrior, always a warrior.
Thank you. Tasia Akuma. Rebecca Lee Alamo, $1,000 Gene M. Shopcott Memorial Scholarship. Nathaniel Isaiah Alisea, National Honor Society, $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship, $2,500 the Leonard N. Snyder Scholarship sponsored by the Grundy Foundation. Lynn A. Anthony, Jr. Rachel Bajorquez, National Honor Society, $250 Puerto Rican Cultural Association of Bucks County Scholarship, $250 Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks Bristol Lodge No. 970 John Berg Bottoms Up Scholarship, $500 Business to Business Association Scholarship, $1,000 Bristol Jewish Center Scholarship, $12,000 Health Partners Foundation Scholarship. Sierra Rose Booth, $1,000 Ruth W. Lubick Scholarship Award. John Burnett, $400 Catherine C. Perella Scholarship. Nicholas Robert Kaywood. Sarah Chilella, National Honor Society, $100 Bristol High School Softball Team Award, $2,500 the Leonard N. Snyder Scholarship sponsored by the Grundy Foundation. Michael Sinar. Tazala Cofield. Alicia Marie Davila, $250, Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks Bristol Lodge No. 970, John Berg Bottoms Up Scholarship, $2,500 Leonard N. Snyder Scholarship sponsored by the Grundy Foundation. Madison Devlin. Nathan Scott Eddings, $350 Bristol Borough Education Association Award, $1,000 Gregory Pinelli Student Athletic Scholarship Award, $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship. Nicholas Eddings. Nicholas Esposito, $250 Police Benevolent Association of Bristol Borough, $500 American Legion Robert W. Bracken Post No. 382, and $1,000 Bristol Lions Club Scholarship. Paige Elizabeth Feeney, National Honor Society, Phi Beta Kappa Book Award, $250 Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks Bristol Lodge No. 970 John Berg Bottoms Up Scholarship, $300 Bristol Borough Library Award, $1,000 Ruth W. Lubick Scholarship Award, $4,000 Alice L. Johnson Charitable Trust Scholarship, and $24,000 Temple University Academic Scholarship. Rachel Fries. Jacob Bersani Fry, Salutatorian, Student of the Year, National Honor Society, $500 Bristol Borough Business Association Student of the Year Award, $1,000 Foundations Community Partnership Award, $1,000 Elsie and Charles Richmond Scholarship for Academic Excellence, $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship, $2,000 Allied Electronics Student of the Year Scholarship, and $4,000 Alice L. Johnson Charitable Trust Scholarship. Dominic Edward Gallagher. Marquise Anthony Golar. Emmanuel Gonzalez, $125 Carmen M. Gonzalez Memorial Scholarship and $1,000 Ruth W. Lubick Scholarship Award. Tyler Corrigan Gonzalez, $100 America Hose Hook and Ladder Company No. 2 Award, $125 Carmen M. Gonzalez Memorial Scholarship, $250 Puerto Rican Cultural Association of Bucks County Scholarship, and $8,000 Kutztown Academic Scholarship. Jalen Hammond, $500 Independent Order of Odd Fellows Hopkins Lodge No. 87, $1,000 Bristol Lions Club Scholarship, and $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship. Alyssa Marie Januska, $500 Bristol High School Mothers Association Award, $500 the Israel Elizabeth and Samuel Surratt Memorial Scholarship, sponsored by Jack Surratt, $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship, and $12,000 Health Partners Foundation Scholarship. Rachel Kelly, $100 William McHugh Memorial Scholarship. Jordan Maldonado. Emily E. Marchese, National Honor Society, $500 Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks Bristol Lodge No. 970, John Berg Bottoms Up Scholarship, $1,000 Gregory Pinelli Student Athletic Scholarship Award, $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship, $1,250 the Leonard N. Snyder Scholarship sponsored by the Grundy Foundation, $2,000 Bristol Alumni and Athletic Association Scholarship Outstanding Female Athlete. Walter James McGauley V, Alexander Nicholas Murphy, Paul Anthony Nieves, Dominic Nacido III, Michael Joel Ocasio, Daniel Tanzano, National Honor Society, $1,000 Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks Bristol Lodge No. 970, John Berg Bottoms Up Scholarship, $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship, $1,500 Today Incorporated Foundation Scholarship, $2,000 Bristol Alumni and Athletic Association Scholarship Outstanding Male Athlete. Dylan J. Patty, $500 Nada M. Lutz Attendance Scholarship, $1,000 Ruth W. Lubick Scholarship Award. Aishan Perry, National Honor Society, $500 Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks Bristol Lodge No. 970, John Berg, Bottoms Up Scholarship. $500 Levittown Bristol Kiwanis Club Scholar Athlete of the Year. $1,000 Greg Pinelli Student Athletic Scholarship Award. And $2,000 Bristol Alumni and Athletic Association Scholarship. Casey Colleen Pinelli, National Honor Society. $500 Levittown Bristol Kiwanis Club Scholar Athlete of the Year. $1,000 Greg Pinelli Student Athlete Scholarship Award. $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship. And $1,250 the Leonard N. Snyder Scholarship sponsored by the Grundy Foundation. Paige Catherine Pinelli. $100 America Hose Hook and Ladder Company No. 2 Award. $500 Bristol Alumni and Athletic Association Scholarship in memory of Raymond Naylor. $500 the Israel Elizabeth and Samuel Surratt Memorial Scholarship sponsored by Jack Surratt. $500 Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks Bristol Lodge No. 970 John Berg Bottoms Up Scholarship. And $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship. Gianni Catroci, Valedictorian, National Honor Society. $250 Bristol High Athletic Boosters. $250 Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks Bristol Lodge No. 970 John Berg Bottoms Up Scholarship. $300 Delaware Science Council Scholarship. $500 Fidelity Savings Achievement Award. $1,000 Gene M. Shapcott Memorial Scholarship. $1,000 Elsie and Charles Richmond Scholarship for Academic Excellence. $1,000 Bristol Rotary Club Scholarship. Sinelli Nicole Rivera. $250 the Anthony Macaluso Memorial Scholarship. Nomar Tyler Rodriguez Morales. Catherine Carolina Romero Hueso. Nathan James Root. Allison Schmuckler. Shane Ryan Stanley. Salvatore Tassone, National Honor Society. $250 Bristol High Athletic Boosters. $500 Edna L. Schaefer Memorial Scholarship. $1,000 Gene M. Shapcott Memorial Scholarship. Jadalyn Vargas. $250 Puerto Rican Cultural Association of Bucks County. $500 Celtic Heritage Foundation Scholarship for Outstanding Community Involvement. $500 Fidelity Savings Achievement Award. And $500 Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks Bristol Lodge No. 970 John Berg Bottoms Up Scholarship. Sinai Shakira White. Jabrea Williams. $100 American Hose Hook and Ladder Company No. 2 Award. $500 Celtic Heritage Foundation Scholarship for Outstanding Community Service. And $500 Independent Order of Odd Fellows Hopkins Lodge No. 87.
Dr. Minetti, members of the Board of Education. The faculty of Bristol High School has certified to me that the members of the class of 2020 have fulfilled the requirements of the Bristol Borough School District and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and are eligible for graduation. Members of the class of 2020, by the power granted to me by the Bristol Borough School District and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I declare you to be graduates of Bristol High School. You may move your tassel from the right side to the left side. Congratulations.
Good morning, board members, administration, teachers, staff, and fellow classmates. My name is Michael Ocasio, and I am the BHS Student Council President. Upon graduating, I will be shipping out to begin my journey in the United States Navy. Growing up, we all fantasized about what high school would be like, the classes, famous pep rallies, football games, and much more. As I stand here today, I am happy to announce that high school is nothing like the movies. There isn't anyone jumping on tables and singing like in High School Musical, and there aren't any crazy football games Friday nights with 1,000 people in the stands cheering like in All-American. But the one thing those movies and shows have in common is that there is always a teacher who supports the student to the fullest. Someone who doesn't give up on them. The main character's hero, if you will. Whether you realize it or not, we all have a hero in our story. For me, their names are Mrs. Albright, or as we know her, Mrs. Algebra, and Mrs. Lafreda. Without these teachers, I would not be standing here giving you this speech. They cared for me and supported me as if I were their own son. Thank you for everything that you've done for me, not only for myself, but as my class as well. We can all agree that this year was not how we hoped it would be. An event that will change the way we live was sweeping around the globe, and it found you. As your long, strange spring break was extended week after week, the truth began to sink in. You will never go back to high school, not as a student anyway. That part of your life had ended, and you never got to say goodbye to it. This will forever be a senior year to remember. Although we didn't get a chance to say goodbye, our memories will always connect us to one another. The jokes during class, walking down the hall with your group of friends, our intense powder puff games, the times where we asked to go to the bathroom just because we didn't feel like being in class, hearing the words, "Mr. Gatto, please report to the office," for the thousandth time in a day, trying to sneak past Miss Laura after the bell rings so you don't get a detention, the smell of onions and peppers being cooked down the hall in Miss Martinez's room, all of the doors in the hallway being slammed shut because Dr. Smith was so loud, and my personal favorite, getting yelled at by Mrs. Rosado for having a hoodie on. As I sit back and think about all of this, I can't do anything but smile. I will always use these memories to define high school. One of the most important things I've learned throughout these past 4 years is that you are the only person who decides what high school will be like. You can choose to just sit there and do nothing, or you can become involved and make friends and memories that you will remember forever. I would like to thank Dr. Minitti for being the coolest superintendent I've ever met. Although we didn't get a full senior year with you, I personally want to thank you for always sitting down to talk to us and getting to know us, not only as a class, but as individuals. I wish you nothing but the best. To the class of 2021, live your senior year to the fullest, because as you can see, it can end so fast. I wish you nothing but the best and hope that you all enjoy your last year in high school. Thank you to my fellow classmates and most importantly, my friends and family for making high school one to remember. Good luck to you all in your future endeavors. As the late Kobe Bryant once said, the most important thing in life is to try to inspire people so that they can be great in whatever they want to do. I hope as a class we have inspired everyone to fulfill your dreams no matter the price. And on behalf of Class of 2020, peace out.
Through the twilight haze of memory, loyally we cling to the red and gray of Bristol, praise will ever sing. Ever onward, ever upward, hold your colors high. Hail to thee, O alma mater, hail to Bristol High. Though we leave thee, dear old Bristol, memories still remain of the days we spent in building your undying name. All the fields of your endeavors pass before our eyes. Comradeship no time can sever, wrapped in friendship ties. Thank you.
discouraged. Don't shy away, cause you know you're close to shining through. When there's nothing that can stop you, if you just keep believing, just keep the faith, you'll see. Well, everything's about to change, yeah. It's the start of a brand new succeed. And you're standing on the precipice. Take a leap of faith cause you won't miss. Work up the courage. You're one step from taking flight. Everything's gonna be alright today. Start of a brand new day. It's the start of a brand new day.
Together, light it up, we can. can be a million stars. Look at us, don't you see we've come so far? Yeah, we've come so far. 'Cause this is our world, and this is our time, and these are our plans. We're gonna let them shine. This is our place in the human race. And we won't stop dreaming. No, we won't stop dreaming. Standing at the crossroads, feeling how the wind blows, we can soar above the clouds. Every moment is a heartbeat, and every breath feeling so sweet. And who can say what happens now? 'Cause this is our world, this is our time, these are our plans. We're gonna let them shine. This is our place in the universe.